You guys, this is madness. This is just October. Hello there, everybody. How's it going? It's Jesse from Jesse Marie Does Stuff coming to you on this Saturday. Yeah, it's a Saturday. It's October the 29th, 2016, and I am here with the October portion of my update. Oh, we have so much to discuss. Since, you know, it's been like a whole month, and I have a whole month of projects to update you on. I mean, there's so many here. And there's a couple of events going on. So there's like a ton of projects here. Some of which are going to be referenced like three or four times. I was getting my notes together to do this video, and I'm like, okay. So there's that project there, and then it's there and there again. My notes are like forever long. It's a little crazy. But here we are. We're gonna do it. We're playing catch up here. It is about 3 o'clock in the afternoon here in Virginia, and what that means at the end of October is that the sun is gonna go away real quick. And as such, I'm going to abbreviate this in the way that I know how, and that's sort of to save some things for my regularly scheduled update. So I'm not going to go over the Q&A today, and I'm also, I guess that's really all I've left out because I'm talking projects, I'm talking plans for the next few days. I've got some acquisitions. And I'm going to talk as briefly as I possibly can about books. But I'm going to try to streamline this as best as possible. It is Saturday, and so that means that Danny is here. He is currently outside doing some yard work. So if you hear the lawnmower or some grumbling and moaning, that's what that is. But he is also watching football. He's got the, I'm not sure if it's Penn State. I don't know what game he's got playing. Anyway, he's out there. Thor is out there with him. Thor's not going to come in here because this is insanity. What else? The other reason that I'm not doing the Q&A today is that I cannot physically get through reading the comments from my last video without tearing up. I'm serious. You guys are, like, the greatest people, and I just want to thank you so much for your support. You know, it's a complicated thing that I talk about all the time, us being strangers and all, but you guys really warmed my heart over the last few days while reading your comments as they came in. I haven't replied to any because the sentiments are so heartfelt, it's almost overwhelming. So just know that I really do appreciate everything that you've said and all of your love and support that have come towards me these last few days. Means a lot. Okay, I'm not going to get teary-eyed. I just put in brand new contacts. And if for all the contact wearers out there, you know that if you cry in your contacts, they're dead. And these are brand new, so I'm not going to cry in these. Okay, so this video was promised on Wednesday, but like Wednesday got away from me super fast. Like all of a sudden Wednesday was over and I was like, crap, I was supposed to record today. It's just one of those days. And then So Danny and I did the spouse cross stitch quiz on Saturday afternoon before Virginia Tech played Syracuse, and I have since decided that I'm not recording on game day anymore because we lost that game and we had no business losing that game. So, I'm not recording on game days anymore. It's sports fans are the most superstitious people you will ever meet. So I'm trying to save Virginia Tech from losing as best I can. And we played on Thursday night this week, so I wasn't going to record on Thursday. Yesterday, I had a terrible migraine, so yeah, there was no recording yesterday. So here we are today, which is cool. I'm not used to recording on Saturday. I'm not used to recording in the hearing of my husband, but hey, you know, we'll make it work. So I'm talking about this streamline. We're trying to hurry up, trying to be quick today. 5.5 minutes in, probably should start showing stuff. So I'm going to pull up my notes and move them over here so that they're not in my field of view. There we go. All right, let's scroll up to the top. This is going to be interesting. Okay, so I'm going to kind of do things in an order that makes sense to me. So I'm going to start with my works in progress that I have worked on since October 1st. And then I've got my planned WIPs for the next few days until my video on Wednesday. Then we're going to talk stitch-alongs and then plans for these various stitch-alongs. Okay, so first week in my rotation is my sales week. And my sales for the month of October were to be my fantasy sal by Lakeside Needlecraft and Doreen Jones, as well as the postcards from the world from Clouds Factory. So the first one I worked on, because it comes out, technically I started this on September the 30th, but so this one releases midnight UK time, which is about 7 o'clock the night before for me. So I got started on it and worked on it real fast. So I'm going to insert a preview here of what it looked like last time. And here is what it looks like today. So there we have it. And I'm just going to fold up a little bit and zoom in on our little witchy girl here, who I think is super adorable. I stitched her skin 1/1 because, you know, that's what I do. And yeah, I'm pretty pleased with the progress that I made. The fabric here is 32 count Belfast linen in Heroic by Picture This Plus. Here's a preview of what the whole thing looks like as of now. Quite a lot of work left to do, but I am, for the most part, prepared for when the next block comes out Monday evening. And it will go in that empty spot right there. So there we have it. That is the fantasy sale. I did see that Lakeside has announced their next collaborative stitch along for 2017, and it is Under the Sea. So that's fascinating. I'm waiting to see what Clouds Factories is, and I'm kind of waiting to see if I'm going to do the Lakeside Needlecraft, because I have so many sales going right now that I may take it back one, at least. So, fantasy sal. There we go. Okay, my next sal for my sales week is the Clouds Factory Postcards from the World, so preview here of what that looked like last time. Basically, the last time you saw it, I had the top 9 blocks done, and now I have the 10th one done. And this go-round, we were in New York. I worked on this so long ago that I almost forgot what the block was, despite my love affair with New York. So there we have it. I really like this block. The only thing I don't like is that there's supposed to be some contrast in Lady Liberty's hair. Obviously, she's a statue, so there is no actual contrast, but it's supposed to look like it. You can barely see it, but that's okay. Not a big deal. This block took an extraordinary amount of time. I'm not entirely sure why this one took me so long, but it took me maybe 3 days. Yeah, I think about 3 days. But then I also went through and filled out the rest of the frames. So I am all caught up on the frames. And then I was missing some of the little extras up top here, the little bubbles off to the side and the kind of snowflake looking motifs there in the middle. I filled all that out. So really all that's left to do is fill in these two blocks. And then those with the more astute eyes will notice that the bubble is missing from here. That's because that's where my signature will go, in place of the bubble. I figure that was appropriate. So there is my postcards from the world. And this is on a 28 count Monet cashel linen from Picture This Plus. Okay. Two down. 85 to go. Not 85, but like, you know, quite a lot. Okay. Next, week two is my Heaven and Earth Designs week. And this go around, I decided to switch it up and work on In This Moment by Jeremiah Kettner. The last time that I talked about my Heaven and Earth Designs week, I think it was in one of my September updates. Not the last one that I just did a few days ago, but actually in September. I had sort of contemplated sticking with Faces of Fairy to finish the page or moving on in my rotation. Well, it ended up working out best to move on in my rotation because of the monthly Sal and Stitch Mania. So that's what it did. So this is what this project will look like finished. This is my absolute favorite piece of artwork that Heaven and Earth Designs has available. Jeremiah Kettner is one of my favorite artists, and I absolutely adore this piece. And this piece is huge. It's 525 by 529, so about 21 inches square on 25 count 1/1. So, preview here of what it looked like the last time you saw it. This piece I started in 2015. I got the first couple columns done and haven't worked on it since. So I gave it some good love. I'll try to navigate this fat half of Lugana here, which, by the way, is a 25 count Lugana, and it is in cream, I believe, or off-white or antique white or something to that effect. It's a not white neutral. Page finish. Good grief, Jess. Okay, there we go. That's better. Got the page finish. Look at how pretty that is, you guys. I love the kind of floral bits. So that's in like this region right here. I think it looks so good. So good. There's so much confetti in there. It doesn't look like there would be, but there are approximately 18 shades of magenta and plum to make up that. Oh, I love it. I absolutely love it. I did have just over half of a page to finish up in order to get the page finished, as you saw in the preview. But I powered through and got it done. And let me just open this up so you can see scale. How much I have done versus how much I have left to do. Quite a lot. Okay, and there is that. Okay, so then after my Heaven and Earth Designs week on the 9th, I actually ended up with a new start. What prompted this new start was a desire to stitch while watching football with Danny, but not really having anything that was Q-snap friendly that was at a good place to be stitching on while watching football. So I decided to make a new start. It was actually kind of serendipitous because I was looking for a Halloween project and I don't really have, I mean, I have Haunted House and Horror Movie Alphabet, but I have a few haunted-like pieces, but I don't necessarily have a Halloween piece. Then I'm putzing around on Instagram, and I see that Colbin has mentioned this project here. This is Halloween in Quilt, and I'm going to insert the name here because I am not going to mispronounce it. But I thought that this was just stupid adorable. And so I went ahead and ordered it and got it started. So there's that. And I will include the link to the Etsy shop where this project is, where the pattern you can buy it from. The thing about it is that it is an Italian-based designer, and so you have to tell them in the comments that you want the PDF version. At that point, they will refund your shipping costs, because otherwise they're going to send you a hard copy. So just be aware of that, but I will link that in the description box. So this piece is still on my Q-Snap because I do work on it on Football Sunday sometimes. Sometimes I don't. But this is the progress that I got so far. And this is just the top border. And I'm stitching it on a 32-count cream Belfast linen from Zweigart. And the color palette just makes me happy. I've got it here. It is tangled. Well, I wanted to show you the color palette. There we go. There we go. So you can see just some beautiful oranges. There's black, of course. I love the green and purple together. Those are pretty great. So this is a really cute design, and it's all in DMC. It's all charted in DMC. And I'm looking forward to making more progress on it. It's going to be a slow project, and it will likely be put away after Halloween on Monday in lieu of something else to stitch on during Halloween, or during football, excuse me. But we will see. Okay. Then on, can't remember what date it was, so never mind that. My week three of my rotation is my focus for a finished piece. So this is one of my final eight pieces, as I've said so many times. From the beginning of the year, I said I wanted to finish these eight projects, and that is my focus for week three of each month. So for October, that piece was Stretch by Teresa Wentzler, and I'll insert a preview here of what it will look like finished, as well as the progress that I had made the last time I worked on it. And I stitched this on a 32 count cream Belfast linen from Zweigart, and I say stitched in past tense because it's done. So I finished Stretch, and I just love him. This is all done in DMCs, but the depth of color is achieved because Teresa Wentzler, as so many of you know, is a big fan of blends. Oh, I just love it. Let's see if I can bring it in close here. Catch the light. Favorite part, easily, that wing. Love that wing. There's also a world of backstitch and fractional stitches. If you don't like backstitch, do not with a Teresa Wentzler. I would also advise against using Ada for a Teresa Wentzler project, only because of the prevalence of fractional stitches. But when I posted about this on social media, somebody told me that they just finished a Teresa Wentzler on Ada. And they are my hero. Because I couldn't even imagine having to stab through the fabric that many times. You can see my signature there, the Jessica stitch. There is an S in the middle, and then the year in Roman numerals is down there, hiding amongst the knotwork. So there is Stretch. Achievement unlocked, Teresa Wentzler. Okay, so next started my week four of my rotation. Now, as you guys know, week four of my rotation is a daily rotation through the alphabet of my whips for my Year of Whips challenge, not including any of the other ones. That's such a long title, but you guys understand. I've explained it before. So let me go ahead and pull up my notes again because they disappeared on me. And we'll talk through. So I started October at the very beginning of the alphabet with this Year of Whips challenge. I just wanted fresh slate starting from the top. Very first on that list is April by the Cricut Collection. And this project I haven't worked on since my birthday, actually. The last time I worked on it was April 25th. And you'll be seeing a preview here of what it looked like the last time you saw it. I am stitching this on a Witchelt fabric, and it is, I believe it's a 32 count dove gray linen. And I lost the thing. The thing came out of it, but that's okay. So here is the progress that I made. This piece is going to need a serious bath and iron because this crease down the middle here, it's a stubborn one. So I'm going to have to definitely iron that out. But I made some pretty decent progress that day. I finished up the umbrella itself. I did the top part of the I as well as the top part of the L. And then I also came over here and worked on the flowers underneath the A. They're not quite finished yet, but I did work on them. There's a lot of confetti in those flowers. I mean, confetti, you know, it's a very relative term, but there's a ton of colors. And this one are the same, but this one in the center here is a little bit different. It's different colored. So I contemplated, and I ho-hummed about this and thought about it back and forth. Should I stick with this project until it's finished because the Year of Whips challenge, or should I just move on in my rotation like I'm supposed to? Well, obviously I did not just finish it and I ended up moving on in my rotation because all of my projects need to get their due effort. So that is April. And this one, it'll be a quick finish once I can get back to it, but maybe a couple more stitching days, and that will see that done. Okay, up next I'm going to insert a preview here of what it will look like finished. This is Big Bang Theory, and it is by Wee Little Stitches, the original Pixel People. You'll also be seeing a preview of what it looked like the last time you saw it. This was a Stitch Mania start. And I'm stitching it on 32 count Dill Belfast from Picture This Plus. And I have two very funky looking characters from Big Bang Theory here. So Penny is missing her middle as well as her lips. But she did get shoes and eyeballs this go around. And then Rajesh is missing one leg entirely, much of the other leg. And lips. And hands. He also doesn't have hands. But I really like the way they're turning out so far. I love Rajesh's outfit. I think it's just it's so perfect. So, very cool. I love Big Bang Theory. It appeals to all of my nerdy happiness. So, there's that. I gotta tell you, in person, this fabric is a lot deeper, but I do like the way that it looks. Oh gosh, I'm showing you the back of my stitching. I really don't want to do that. I like the way it looks on camera. So that's cool. Okay. Up next is another project. I will insert a preview here of what it will look like finished. I am stitching the Christmas Star by Liz Almond. This was also a Mania start. And preview here of what it looked like last time. I am stitching this piece a total of 8 times. However, for this whip, I'm counting it 4 times. So the original color palette calls for a majority red with green and gold accents. So I'm stitching 2 like that. Then I'm stitching it twice in the opposite, where it's majority green with red accents and gold accents. The other 4 are the same variations of blue, white, and silver. So, anyway, this first set is on 28 count antique white Kesha linen from Swagart. And here is what it looks like now. Now, this was a piece that I thought for sure I would get to work on it and I would finish it because it is super fast. I mean, each of those Christmas stars, it doesn't take too terribly long. There are a total of 64 eyelets in each of them, plus the gold accents. Let's see, this one up top is an eyelet, and then this is a modified eyelet down there. So, I mean, they're quick, but they're a little bit more complex than I thought that they were. So I got about halfway through the second one and most of the way through the first one. I decided to just move on. Now I am making some changes with this. It calls for a gold credit and I am using Petite Treasure Braid number 26, which is a gold. And then it also calls for beads. I'm not using the beads because these are going to be Christmas cards. So, family, one of these will be coming to live with you. Probably, if I can get them done in time. I don't know that I will. But, nonetheless. So, that is my Christmas stars. Okay. What are you? Oh, yeah. Okay. Up next is Cross Stitch Lover. This is by Ursula Michaels, and it is from the Just Cross Stitch January-February 2016 issue. Preview here of what it will look like finished, as well as where it was the last time you saw it. Again, this was a Mania start, and I haven't worked on it since Mania. And I'm stitching this also on 32 count cream Belfast linen from Zweigart. So this is the progress that I made. Essentially, everything in purple is what I did on Thursday, maybe? I don't remember. And I have subbed out all of the colors for Weeks Dye Works and a couple of Petite Treasure Braids. I used an antique dark gold to stitch the needle so it sparkles a little bit. That purple is amethyst, which is really just, I mean, it's a soft lavender purple, hardly any variegation at all, which I'm okay with. I had all of the troubles with that thread knotting, but I think it's okay. And I really like the font that Ursula Michael uses. I think they're really, really fun fonts. So we have needle, shop, symbols, favorite designer. And that is the end of the purple for this design. So the next time I work on this, I'll pick a different color. So there's that. Okay. That's it for the whips. So, next we're going to talk about my planned whips for the next few days. Essentially, the way that this week is working out is that if my project for the Election Day sale is a Year of Whips piece, then I am only working on that piece that day and I'm not doing a whip on top of it. So, for instance, tomorrow, and I'll show it to you here in a second, my project for that is Rose Fairy by Jonah Elliott. That is one of my Year of Whips pieces, so that is the only project I'm working on. I'm not adding another whip to it. Today, however, my elections piece, my election sal piece, was the 20-year celebration by Passione Ricamo. So because that's not a Year of Whips piece, I am going to be working on one of my Year of Whips rotation pieces. I hope that you guys can follow that. Basically, what this means is that I only have one actual whip left for the rest of October, which is the next 2.5 days. Anyway, So, that piece in question is the Darth Vader Sugar Skull by Stitchline on Etsy. And this is the progress that I have made thus far. And I'll work on this afternoon. Or this evening, by the time this is done uploading. And I am stitching this on a 32-count Stormy Clouds linen by Zweigart. It is a printed fabric, so the backside is plain. And I'm stitching it using DMC 3799. And I'm hoping to get some good progress on it tonight, but we shall see. So there is that. Okay. Then, by the time I record next, I will be in the midst of my week one of my rotation, since November starts on Tuesday. So I'll be pulling out my Fantasy Sal by Lakeside Needlecraft and Durin Jones. That will probably release Monday evening, so I'll get to work on that. And then the Postcards from the World will release early Tuesday morning, so I will be working on those, and I'll update you on Wednesday. Okay. Next, we're going to move on to the Sal's section. So the first stitch along that I want to talk to you guys about is the Babson Smalls. We love them all. This is the month-long stitch along hosted by Stitch Mania. And it was a Sal where you worked on your BAPS, which stands for Big Projects. And your smalls, so your smallest pieces. So my week one, because I split this up and divided in the weeks, my week one was the Blue Ridge Santa, and this is by Mill Hill, so it was a small. I started small. You'll be seeing a preview here of what it looked like. Last time this was a Stitch Mania start, and I hadn't worked on it since. And so I worked on this a little bit every day for a week, and I finished it. So there we have it. This is my Blue Ridge Santa. I'm going to rearrange here so I can hold on to him and show him to you. He's really middle heavy. There's a lot of beads there in the center, so every time I grab him. And I'm going to tilt it so you can see just all of the beads in there. Very beaded, very sparkly. I love him. And because I've had a couple weeks separation from that beard, I don't hate it. Let me just tell you guys, doing that beard was intense, and I was really, really fighting with it. I managed to get it done. It took two tries, but I managed to get it done. And then I was like, I can't even look at him right now because I'm so mad, but I think he turned out really cool. Little raccoon. This little basket over here, I think he's super cool. So yeah, this is not my smallest Mill Hill kit that I currently have on the go, but I kind of wanted one that would take up the whole week, a project that I could work on for this whole Monday through Friday-ish span. So that's what I did for that. And all finished. So now I have two of my 34 Year of Whips projects done, which is really exciting. We're only not even through the first month of it, and I'm already down two. So that's cool. They're smalls because stretch is also, you know, it's pretty small. But anyway, making progress. So then, week two was In This Moment by Jeremiah Kettner. So I essentially was working on that for both my whip, for it being my Heaven and Earth Designs week, as well as my Babson Smalls, We Love Them All piece. So that is one of my largest whips, if not the largest. I haven't done the stitch count on Snow Queen or the overall size of Snow Queen. But no, I guess she's not. She's not as big. Anyway, In This Moment is my BAP. And so I worked on that for that whole week. And that was the only project that I worked on that week. So that was kind of cool because I could just focus in on it. Week three, my BAPs and Smalls, We Love Them All, is Stretch. Or was Stretch. And so I went ahead and just focused on that piece that entire week, and that's what was able to lead to the finish of it. So that was pretty cool. That stretch by Teresa Wentzler, I showed that to you earlier. Week four was originally going to be my Prairie Schooler alphabet. And the reason that I considered that piece for this is that it is a BAP in the sense that it's going to overtake three pieces of fabric, because I'm doing 9 letters per piece of fabric in 3 rows of 3. But it's also kind of small because it's on 40 count, so the stitches are itty bitty teeny tiny, right? Well, that has changed, and so I did work on it as such for one day. So these are just the covers of the two that I've already started. So there we have it. And here is the progress. Here's what it looked like the last time you saw it. And here is the progress that I have made thus far. So essentially for that one day, I finished up these blue waves, and that's all I did. I was not feeling the 40 count that day, and so very limited progress. So there's that. The next day, for the Stitch Mania Elections Challenge, I was working on my horror movie alphabet by Clouds Factory. And I ended up deciding to switch out this last week for that horror movie alphabet for a couple of reasons. First of all, it's Halloween, and I kind of just wanted to give it some more attention, it being October and it being horror movie season. On top of that, it kind of fits the bill as well, because it is a BAP in the sense that there are 26 characters, but it's also small because each one is like a little mini finish. Finish a character. Ooh, I gotta finish. So I'm counting it. And so I switched it out, and I have since been working on my horror movie alphabet since that day. So here is a preview of what it will look like finished, as well as what it looked like the last time you saw it. I'm stitching this piece on 32 count Lycan's Moon Belfast from Under the Sea Fabrics. And this is after a few days of work, about an hour a day, give or take. So there we have it. So essentially I started off with finishing up Otis Driftwood and Pinhead. They needed their red accents before I could call them done. Then I worked my way up and finished up Freddy Krueger. There's a mistake in Freddy, but I'm not going to point it out to you. And then I decided to work up and over so that I could start from the very beginning. I'd started in the middle because Otis and Pinhead are respectively Danny and I's favorite horror movie. They're characters from our favorite horror movies. So he likes the Rob Zombie House of a Thousand Corpses. I love the Hellraiser series. So I wanted to start with those two, which I thought was just perfect that they were together. But then I decided that it would be a lot easier if I could just start from the top and then work my way down afterwards. So that's what I did. And so I have the names done, and then I'll start filling in the characters for Jack Attack, Beetlejuice, Chucky, Dracula, Elvira, and Frankenstein's Monster, which I haven't yet backstitched the monster. So there we have it. And this fabric is showing up really well on the camera today, which I really like to see. Brittany from Blind the Cat Stitches calls this Dried Blood. It is the most perfect name. Absolutely love that. So that's my horror movie alphabet. That's got to get some more work here today. And I'm going to work on that for about an hour through the end of October. Choo! Okay, so that's what I worked on for the BAPs and Smalls. We love them all. Next was the Color a Day challenge on Stitch Mania, and this happens on the 24th of each month. For October, it was Catch the Rainbow. And so the task was to work on a variegated color. Well, I have a perfect project for the variegated color, and that is my recipe for a magical night by Alessandra Adelaide. Here's the black and white, or black and gray version, I guess, of what the chart will look like finished. And I showed this to you guys earlier this week already, but I'm just going to show it to you again just for the placeholder. This is on a 28 count Lugana in Misty Morning from Under the Sea Fabrics. And here's where it stands currently. So on the day of the stitch along, I finished up the blue smoke tendril there, and then I added in the purple and orange one. And that's the progress that I got done for the sale that day. So, super fun. I'm having fun with this piece. It's terrifying. I've gone over it, but still, I'm enjoying it. Okay. Next was the Now I Know My ABCs. This is a sale hosted by Cross Stitch Finish Line. This is on the 26th of each month, signifying the letters of the alphabet. There are 26 letters, so it takes place on the 26th. This month, we were to focus on the letter E. It just so happens that on that day, I stitched the Elvira on my horror movie alphabet. That counts for E. I decided not to pull out my Prairie Schooler alphabet for that day because I had already stitched an E and I just wasn't feeling the 40 count. Not to mention, with this election sale going on right now, I'm working on so many projects in a day that it's almost overwhelming. And that was on Thursday. Anyway, it was just a lot of projects in one day. And so I just decided to stick with the progress that I had made for Horror Movie Alphabet. So that's that. Okay. Next, we have some upcoming sales. One. Technically, this is a sale that has already started. This is a, it's a sale between me and Stitching May, and we are working on Be Thankful by Diane Arthurs for Imaginating. And this is a piece that I started last year, but I haven't finished yet, obviously. And we are working on this on Friday. So I haven't mentioned this to Stitching May yet, but I'm calling this the Be Thankful It's Friday sale. And so that is what we're doing. So we're working on this piece every Friday. I haven't worked on mine yet. Last week, we were getting home from the Thursday night football game. So that was crazy. And then yesterday, like I said, I was dealing with my migraine. So I am going to work on this today. But I'm just going to go ahead and give you guys some reference of where I am currently with it. And so that's where I am. This is on a 14 count Fiddler's Ada. It's my only Ada piece. This is one of my focus for finished pieces for the year, as well as one of my Year of Whips. So I'm really excited to be just chugging along working on this solidly every Friday. So there we have it. Quite a bit left to do, but that's okay. The last time I worked on this, I got into a really good rhythm with it, so I'm thinking that when I pull this out today, I'm going to see what I can do. I'm going to see if I can work my way up, because I am stitching this design sideways for this year. I don't have a frame that's that orientation, so I stitch it sideways, which is fine. It makes the back look really interesting because the, you know, the backs of your stitches normally go up and down while these are going side to side. A little different. So there we have it. So that is my Be Thankful It's Friday sale. Even though I don't think Friday means the same thing to Stitching May and I as it does to other people. Okay. Alright, so now we're going to switch over and talk about this election sale. I mentioned it in the event page, but I'm not going to do the slideshow updates for this sale. I'm just going to update you guys on it in each of my update videos because This one is only 15 days. It's not as long. Well, I guess. I just kind of, I don't feel the need to do a separate video for it. Part of it is because I did include the AdSense. And so to put up a 3-minute video with a 2-minute ad in front of it, just, it seems kind of silly. So I am, instead, I'm just going to update you in my videos and I'm going to separate it out into this separate section so we can talk about what I have worked on as well as what's coming up for this Elections Day sale. So this is an event that started on October the 25th, and the very first day of the challenge was in reference to red states, so we had to stitch something red. I mentioned to you guys that I had to finish up the red for my horror movie alphabet in Otis Driftwood as well as Pinhead, and so that's what I did for this day. Hence the reason this project was in my mind for the BSLA cell. So that's what I did on that very first day of the stitch along. Next, the second day was in reference to build a wall. And so our task was to work on something with a wall in it. And so I decided to work on my Game of Thrones house banners because there's a bunch of castles there and you can't have a castle without a wall in Heather's Stitches fashion. Duh. So here is a preview of what that looked like the last time that I showed it to you. I'm stitching this on a 28 count cashel linen from Picture This Plus in Ale. And here is the progress that I have made thus far. So since I've already finished up the castle itself for Winterfell, I decided to work on some of the decoration. So I worked on the tapestry, the banner itself. So that will help decorate the walls at Winterfell. And I just worked on a wall of white. Super boring, but made interesting by that the S for Stark. There in the center. I'm trying to figure out how to navigate the light. There we go. So there's that. And that was fun. It was fun to work on that. That is not a Year of Whips piece because this thing is huge. It's so much bigger than you would think originally. But anyway. Okay. The next day was Reader Day. This was on Thursday and I was so sad because Virginia Tech played football on Thursday night, so my stitching time was very limited. It was an away game, so I was watching the game, but nonetheless, my stitching time was limited, and I couldn't work on the reader and watch football at the same time. But that's okay. The challenge for this day was in reference to blue states, and so we had to stitch something blue. You guys seeing what I'm seeing? Yeah, that's a whole lot of blue in there. So I focused in on her skirts. So you'll be seeing a preview here of what this looked like the last time you saw it. And I am stitching this on a 28 count gingerbread cashel by Picture This Plus. It's cashel linen. And I did, for limited stitching time, I did manage to finish up the blue in her skirt. At least on the bottom half of the pattern. There is still a little bit here on top coming up to her waist. But, let's see, from this dark blue strip right here, over is what I got done that day. So I did pretty good. It is only 3 shades of blue, but I got her skirt done. And I got some time with the reader. I have to remember to put things over here so that you guys can see them. Doesn't that look amazing? There's not even any backstitch in there yet, and it's already just, it looks so good. Favorite whip. Hands down, favorite whip. Of course I say that, and then you know I'm going to say that about the next piece I'm going to show you. So anyway, so that's the reader. Okay. Next was, the task was in relation to the first ever female major party candidate. And so I decided to work on Persephone, who is my leading lady. Started her on January 1st, 2015. And here is a preview of what she will look like, or excuse me, what she looked like last time. This is designed by Mirabilia. I'm stitching it on a 32 count Belfast in Tempest by Hand Dyed Fabrics by Stephanie. And you get that zoomed in view of that preview because I was working on her arm. And so I'm going to bring it in close here and I'm going to cover my mouth while I talk. But basically you can see that I was able to take this shade of skin down to her elbow. And I worked some on the palest shade and brought that down a little bit. So I did some rough math. And before I started stitching, I had a little over 1,500 skin stitches left. Like, that's it for the skin on this project.
Oh my gosh.
The end is in sight. I mean, you know, there's still, as I was saying, 1,000 stitches of hair. There is the wallpaper background, which is done in Karen Water Lilies, which means I have to do every stitch one at a time. And it's not like a simple wallpaper background. It's involved. And then there's the 8 bajillion beads, because this is the heaviest beaded Mirabilia. So, yeah. I have my work cut out for me still. But being that close on the skin is definitely... I mean, I've been working on the skin for over a year now, so obviously not consistently. But still, it feels pretty major to be that far along in the skin and to see the end in sight. So, there's that. Okay. The next piece is the piece that I worked on today. And today, the task was in reference to purple states, so those states that are undecided. Like Virginia, for instance. We're a swing state. So I pulled out a project that it is my oldest whip. And it is up for contention to be a give up, as Jimmy Flosstube would say, as a UFO. Because there's so much left to be doing on this. And I started this thing over 2 years ago. So this is the Passione Ricamo 20-year celebration sal. It's the stitch along from 2014-2015. I'm not even going to insert a preview of what it looked like last time, but I will insert a preview of what it will look like finished. So it was to work on something purple. So I worked on a frame. Now, this is on a fat half of 32 count Belfast in Ariel by Picture This Plus. So I'm just going to scroll up from the top. So there's the bottom. This thing is massive. It's a fat half. As are all Passione Ricamo designs. I mean, they're all just ginormous. So I have reservations about it because it's huge. It's just going to take so long to finish. But then Danny was like, you know, it would be really nice hanging in like a kiddo's bedroom next to like a bookcase or something. I'm like, okay, well that's kind of adorable. So maybe I'll finish it and learn how to sew so I can make a wall hanging because I am not framing a fat half of linen. No. 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 Not professionally, not personally. Gonna have to learn how to sew. So anyway, I work on my election piece for about an hour. The reader got a little extra time because it's the reader. So I worked on that frame there. So there's that. I enjoy the piece, don't get me wrong. It's just that it's so big, and my tastes have changed. I mean, this is not necessarily my style anymore, but c'est la vie. So that is it for what I have worked on for the Elections Day sale. Now let's talk about what I'm going to be working on for the next few days up until Wednesday. Tomorrow is a piece... It is in reference to make whips great again. So essentially pulling out a project that you haven't worked on in the longest amount of time. I have one project that I haven't worked on yet this year, and that is Rose Fairy by Joan Elliott. Ooh. Why don't I go ahead and pull out that cover sheet, because holy glare. So this is the only project from 2015 that I haven't yet worked on this year, which I think is pretty perfect. And like I said before, this is a Year of Whips piece, so I'm going to work on only this project all day tomorrow. And that is, excuse me, this is where I am at currently. So I have just a little bit of her skirt started, but I'm so excited to work on some more Joan Elliott. This is on a 28 count Lugana, I believe. It is by Picture This Plus, and the color is called Confetti. And so it's just yellows with bits of pink and blue. You can kind of see there. The light is just doing strange things, it being 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So there's that. And so I'm going to make some excellent progress on this tomorrow. I can already feel it. Looking forward to it. Next, on Monday, the project for the day is in reference to D is for Democrat. And so we are supposed to work on a project that somehow relates to the letter D. I will be working on my Darth Vader sugar skull. It just so happens that I was able to time this out perfectly, that I could work on a sugar skull, which is very Halloween related, on Halloween, and also meet this D is for Democrat. So I thought it was pretty perfect. So I'll be working on that project. Since it's a Year of Whips piece, it's the only project I'm going to be working on Halloween. So I could finish it. Maybe. There's a lot left to be done on it. Okay. Next, on Tuesday the 1st. I'm trying to think of what the task is in reference to. I know that the task is the project that you have the least amount of progress on. And I'll be working on In This Moment by Jeremiah Kettner and Heaven and Earth Designs for this. Because I have one page done, so that's approximately 3% complete. Yeah, lots left to do on that. I am going to reorganize myself because the glare is getting a little crazy. Okay, next for the election sale, I'm going to be working on The Raven Queen by Mirabilia. So for this day, the task was in relation to R is for Republican. And so we had to stitch on a project that is in relation to R. So, just a reminder, this is The Raven Queen by Mirabilia, Nora Corbett. And I am stitching this piece on a 32 count Haunted by Picture This Plus in a Belfast linen. I showed this project to you guys earlier this week, but here is where I am currently. Everybody's saying that they see a fox. I don't see the fox. Oh, wait, there it is. I see it. So that's his little nose and the snout coming up there. I see it now. Anyway, that's the Raven Queen. So this project will get some attention on sometime Wednesday. The day that I record, I will show you guys what I get done in an hour. So there's that. Okay. My notes have disappeared again. Let me go ahead and pull those up. Okay. Last section of whips that we have to talk about here are my plans for the next month-long stitch along for Stitch Mania. And upcoming is the Old New Borrowed and Blue. Something old, something new, something borrowed, and something blue. So originally I was planning on working on like my wedding sampler and I was trying to figure out a way to make it work like that. But then I had the bright idea to make it a Heaven and Earth Designs crazy month. So my Hades are going to get a lot of attention in November. As such, my week two is not going to be a Heaven and Earth Designs week because I'm working on Heaven and Earth Designs all month long. So I'm just going to go through my plans for each of the weeks. I split it up just as easily as I possibly could. Old, new, borrowed, and blue. So my oldest whip, Heaven and Earth Design, is In This Moment by Jeremiah Kettner. I started that piece in March of 2015, I do believe. So I will be working on that for week one. Week two is new. So I'll be working on Faces of Fairy 201. It is my newest Heaven and Earth Designs. So, quick preview here. This is by Jasmine Beckett Griffith. Again, 25 count Lugana, 1/1 full cross. I just worked on this piece in September, but I'll just go ahead and show you here where I'm at currently. So I have that little bit of that row to do, and then to work my way down the rest of the page. So there's that. Okay. Next, week three, something borrowed. Now, the way that the sal was set up, borrowed could mean a chart you got for free, or a chart that you got as a gift. So this piece that I'm working on was free because it was my reward chart for having finished Mini Pearl. When you finish a Heaven and Earth design, if you submit the required information, and all of the information is on the website somewhere under their reward program, they will send you a chart of your choosing of equal or lesser value. It has to be within a certain time frame. I happen to finish Mini Pearl in that time frame, so that piece is Mini Pirate, and it is by Sabine Rich. I'll insert a preview here of what it will look like finished. My cover page has run away. So this is where I am currently. Again, 25 count Lugana. And this is still in the old method of stitching in columns. But I will convert that once I pull this piece out again during my week three. So there we have it. I haven't worked on this piece in a long time either. Looking forward to getting back to it. Okay. And then last but not least, something blue. April by Anna Dittman. Is that not the epitome of blue? So much blue going on there. So I have two pages done in this one, because I was working on it for the various Heaven and Earth Designs challenges, for a couple of them anyway. And so, you can see columns. You can see columns for real. You can't see this machine. Good grief, the light. There we go. That's better. Oh, there we lost it again. There we go. Okay, so that's the progress that I've made. And so I will work on this during week four and work on some blue. Okay, so those are my projects for the old, new, borrowed, and blue Stitch Long, Stitch Mania. So that's that. And then I will talk about the subsequent weeks of my rotation as it becomes relevant. Oh my gosh, we made it through all of the whips. So, just two more things left to talk about. The first of which is some haul or some retail therapy. So I don't have a whole lot of things that I've acquired over the last month or so, but just a few things. So we will start with, fabric. So the first thing I have here is a 32 count gingerbread by Picture This Plus. And this fabric was acquired for a specific project in mind, and that is October by the Cricut Collection. You will notice that I haven't started October by the Cricut Collection. That's because I had some issues with flossaway bags. I didn't have enough. I just ran out of time. So I might just start this one day, just because I feel like it, because this is my favorite of the whole monthly series. But we'll see. So, that's gingerbread. Next, I have another piece of fabric that was purchased with a project in mind. This is 32 count vintage country mocha by Zweigart. So again, it's a printed fabric where it's not colored on the back, like the stormy clouds. So there's that. And that project is The Needleworker by Little House Needleworks. This is a project that I told you guys is one of my Year of Whips pieces that I haven't started yet. So there is that. I will work on this at some point. At some point I will start it. In all honesty, I might add it in on its alphabetic day when it comes up in my rotation during my week 4. So stay tuned. That will happen soon. All of the hand-dyed threads come with it. Okay, up next I have my two fabrics of the month. The first came from Under the Sea Fabrics, and this is 32 count Belfast in lapis, however you pronounce it. And it is a beautiful blue. See if I can get it to show. It's showing up less blue than it is, but it really is. I mean, it's gorgeous. I haven't the slightest idea what's going on this, but I do adore it. And I am looking forward to Leslie's return once the move is all sorted. So there's lapis. And then we have my very first hand-dyed fabrics by Stephanie Fabric of the Month. Oh, I'm so, so excited. I started to get nervous because she mentioned that this piece, it took a little bit more to dye. I believe it was a multi-step process to dye this particular color. So October 1st came and went and mine hadn't arrived yet. And I was like getting all antsy. But then it showed up a couple days later and oh. So this is also a 32 count Belfast, and this is in Valyrian Steel, which is a Game of Thrones reference. And oh, it is like a deep, unrelenting gray. There are like some subtle purple and green to it, I think. Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely love this fabric. Ugh. Oh. Again, no idea what's going on this. I thought about putting my converted Stargazer on this. It might still happen because it might look nice on that. But it's up for consideration. So that is my Valyrian Steel. And then I have a needle minder. And I'm just going to pin it to the fabric. It's a Groot. Look at Groot. Ain't he cute? So this is from the Guardians of the Galaxy character reference there. The day that this needle minder arrived, I saw the preview for Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, the trailer for it. I'm so excited. I think that Guardians of the Galaxy is my favorite. I can't say that because I love Deadpool and Thor. Guardians of the Galaxy is up there as far as favorites in the Marvel Universe is concerned. So I had to get a little Groot. So there's that. And then I also got the reward chart for having finished the third Heaven and Earth Designs Challenge. So we'll insert a preview of that. And it's really pretty. I don't know that I'll ever stitch it, but it's really pretty. So that was just a section of the stitch in time, as the rest of them have been. Heaven and Earth Designs decided to hold off on the next challenge until next year, so we'll see. We will see. Okay, I have to go grab all of the books. I will be right back and we can talk about books. Okay, so let's talk books briefly as we can. Up first, I'm going to talk about a Stitcher's Book Club. Things have gotten really quiet at Stitcher's Book Club, and part of that is my fault because I haven't been sending out newsletters as I had planned on doing. And part of that is it's just the nature of a book club. I mean, since we're stitchers, most of our time is focused on our stitching. So reading has to take a backseat to that, which is fine. It's totally cool by me. If you guys are concerned that things are too quiet, let me know if there's something more that I can be doing to try to amp up the participation in the group. That being said, for October, our theme was horror. Worked out pretty spectacularly to be horror, considering it being October. So the first of our two books was Anna Dressed in Blood, and this is by Kendare Blake. This is a young adult horror novel, and it's based around ghosts. It's so good. The cool thing about this hardcover copy is, and I don't know that you'll be able to see it. Nope, you can't see it. The text is in a deep, deep, deep red. And it plays with your eyes because you question it. Like, is that really red? It is. It's really red. I have read this book. I read this book back in 2013 the first time. And then I just finished up the audio version for discussion for Stitcher's Book Club. It's pretty excellent. If you're interested in reading it, do so. Don't know what else to say there. Okay, the second book was The Green Mile by Stephen King. And I haven't even yet cracked this. I went to my Barnes & Noble to pick up this book. And it is surrounded by a bunch of trade paperbacks. And all they had for this was this one mass market paperback. I don't know that I've talked to you guys about this, but I don't like mass market paperbacks. I'll buy a hardcover, I'll buy a trade paperback, I'll buy a UK edition. I don't like the mass market, but I wanted to get a hold of it. We were at the bookstore, so I just went with it. It's not terrible. The thing I don't like about it is that it doesn't sit open. And the only way to get it to where it would sit open is to break the spine. Like, the spine is going to crack. It hasn't yet, but it will. So anyway, that's The Green Mile. And I am going to start reading this here in a couple days. It's a little bit late because obviously it's November here in a couple days. But that's all right. Not a big deal. Okay. Up next, we'll talk about the current or the upcoming books for Stitcher Book Club. So the theme for November is fantasy. And the books that were chosen, there's two of them again. The first of which I have here, it is Etiquette and Espionage, and this is by Gail Carriger. Gail Carriger is hilarious. I read the first in her Soulless series, which is called Soulless, and it's basically, it's steampunk, urban fantasy. So there's some mechanical aspects. It takes place in the Victorian era, and but there's also urban fantasy elements to it. So vampires and werewolves and supernatural beings. This Etiquette and Espionage is a spin-off from that series. It takes place in the same universe, but this is for young adults, whereas the Soulless series is for adults. Yeah, there's some very adult themes in that book. But so this is the young adult version. And it is basically, let me just read the inside flap here. 14-year-old Sophronia is a great trial to her poor mother. Sophronia is more interested in dismantling clocks and climbing trees than in proper manners, and the family can only hope that company never sees her atrocious curtsy. Mrs. Temenik is desperate for her daughter to become a proper lady, so she enrolls Sophronia in Mademoiselle Geraldine's Finishing Academy for Young Ladies of Quality. But Sophronia soon realizes that the school is not quite what her mother might have hoped. At Mademoiselle Geraldine's, young ladies learn to finish everything. Certainly, they learn the fine arts of dance, dress, and etiquette, but they also learn to deal out death, diversion, and espionage, in the politest possible ways, of course. Sophronia and her friends are in for a rousing first year's education. Set in the same world as the Parasol Protectorate, This YA series debut is filled with all of the saucy adventure and droll humor Gail Carriger's legions of fans have come to adore. So I imagine that this is going to be a very entertaining read. This is the first in a series of four, I believe, is the total series, which just finished up this year. I'm looking forward to cracking this. I bought this when it first released, way back when. But looking forward to cracking it. The other book in November is The Princess Bride. And I can't think of the author's name of The Princess Bride, but everybody knows The Princess Bride. I don't have a copy of it yet. But yeah, so those are the upcoming books for fantasy for a Stitcher's Book Club. So if you're interested, link in the description box. Go ahead and join. Come and discuss the book with us. Okay. Next, I'm going to talk about my current reads. I am currently reading two books, one of which is an audiobook, and that is His Majesty's Dragon by Naomi Novik. Naomi Novik this year released a very well-recognized bestseller called Uprooted, and it is a fantasy. It's a fantasy standalone, which is very, very rare. You don't see standalones in fantasy very often. But I decided to go back and read one of her older books to sort of get an idea of who she is as a fantasy author. And so I started with His Majesty's Dragon, which is the first in the Temeraire series. This series is it's history reimagined. This is based on the Napoleonic Wars, which is kind of fascinating. It's reimagining the UK and France as if dragons were a part of the military. And so it's based around this main character who is initially, he's a Navy man, and he becomes the handler of this dragon named Temeraire. And because he's a handler of the dragon, he's the only handler, and so he has to now join the Corps. And become an airman. So, it's very interesting. My knowledge of the Napoleonic War, very basic. Very basic. I don't know a whole lot about Bonaparte, or the proceedings of the war. So it's really interesting. I'm getting, like, history, but, like, infused with fantasy. And Temeraire is, like, the most fascinating dragon. I love him. So, if you are interested in history blended with fantasy, I highly recommend it. It's narrated by Simon Vance, who is an excellent narrator, and it's really, really good. So I'm looking forward to continuing with the series and also with more of Naomi's works, because she's pretty talented. Okay, the other book that I'm reading is, I'm reading it in physical format, and it is A Tyranny of Petticoats by, this is edited by Jessica Spotswood. It is 15 stories of bells, bank robbers, and other badass girls. So this is historical fiction by 15 authors, and this is just a list of the authors that are featured in this one. So there are 15 short stories, historical fiction about girls. It's like girl power in various settings across history. They are American stories, all of them. So let's see. I'm just going to review a couple of these. Let's see. The first one takes place in 1710 in British North America. So before the U.S. independence, all the way up to 1968 in Grand Park, Chicago. So it's like about girls in history and like being awesome. The first one was about a girl pirate. One of them is about a descendant of the Gorgons. So they infused a little bit of fantasy in with it. Trying to think of what one of the other ones was. One of them was about a girl in Louisiana during the pre-Civil War. Is it pre-Civil War? Yeah, pre-Civil War, Louisiana, New Orleans specifically. Just, it's fascinating. So highly recommended. Again, if you like some history, but short stories, so they read really quick. It's like 20 pages, and then you've read a story. Really enjoying this. This is actually, it's becoming a series. So the editor, Jessica Spotswood, she is in the process of editing the second volume of these short stories. So looking forward to that. And I love the cover. Isn't that fun? Super fun. So that's it for books. I've talked about that much longer than I intended to, but typical. Okay, guys, without a whole lot of preamble, I am going to head off. The sun is wreaking havoc on this video. And so I will see you guys later.